Welcome to Sky Motoring's Journey to the Clouds with me, Alistair Weaver. Over the next few grueling days, I'll be attempting to drive a Land Rover Discovery 5,000 metres above sea level to the top of the Andes. In the previous episode, I jumped aboard what seemed like a death trap with wings and soaked at my final night of luxury, literally. Coming up, I'll visit the ancient civilization of Kilmers, tackle an off-road section known as the Drama, and sleep under the stars in the world's highest vineyard. We stopped briefly at one of the area's few tourist attractions. Kilmers was once home to 5,000 Indians, until they were sacked by the Spanish invaders in the 1660s. Now all that remains are these ruins and a few friendly llama.
Well, I've been in Argentina less than a day and here's my first llama. Just really not sure quite how friendly I should be. Hello, boy.
Between my furry friends and bed lay some of the trickiest off-road sections we'd encounter on the whole trip. If we didn't make camp by nightfall, we'd be at serious risk, not just of getting lost, but also from the wild pumas who call these mountains home. In these conditions, off-roading alone is a non-starter. At least with Land Rover's experts on hand, someone would hear me scream.
This is the Land Rover equivalent of singing for your supper. Just to reach camp tonight, we've got to complete two extreme manoeuvres. It's what'll separate the off-road heroes from the bedwetting city folk. And now, it's my turn.
Can't do this in Chelsea. Up into the riverbed, eating away a little bit of power.
Just to prove this is for real, there's a guy some Land Rover experienced themselves having some trouble. It's not exactly building confidence in me. One more, even more serious obstacle to go, which has been described only as the Drama. I'm not sure I'd be doing this with my £45,000 car. All seems to be about being really, really smooth with the controls, really, really gentle with the steering, really gentle with the throttle. But the more cars that go up there, the more that these rocks get worn away, the more difficult it becomes. It is incredible to think what these vehicles will do.
Keep going, Weaver. Keep going. Actually, the downhills are more scary because you feel less in control.
One of the sad things about cars like this Discovery is that so many of the people who spend £30,000-£40,000 on them have no real idea of exactly what they can do. And it's only when you get out here into the wilderness that you understand the depth of the engineering and the talent in a vehicle like this.
We made it to camp just as the sun packed up for the day and the pumas came out to play. In front of the sanctity of a campfire, I snatched a word with the man in charge of the whole expedition, Land Rover's David Sneath.
David, you're the man who's guided me over all these obstacles today. How hard is it to bring somebody like me to an environment like this?
Well, as long as you listen, it's very easy indeed. You need to go slowly, but be aggressive when needed. And so therefore, it's really just slow movements of the steering wheel, progressive throttle movement. You will need in certain situations to give it full throttle and then steer accordingly. But at other times, as soon as you come through the sand, as soon as you hit the rocks, slow down. Otherwise, you'll damage your vehicle. And effectively, the vehicle is your link with security and ending the day properly.
It's going to get me home.
Yes, it's going to get you home.
We're actually staying in the highest vineyard in the world, which is at 2,000 metres. It's a place called Colome. The wine's actually really, really good. I'm a little bit concerned tomorrow that we're going up to 5,000 metres, which is another 3,000 metres up. I'm a little bit worried about not only its effect on me, but also on the vehicle. I think it's going to be another very long day in the saddle. We're talking about 10 hours of driving. So I'm going to try and get some sleep now and give it a go in the morning.
On the next episode, we break camp, I buy some cocaine, seriously, and launch my assault on the summit of 5,000 metres.